Election officials in Columbus, Ohio said today there's no way they could have prepared for this. An avalanche of early and absentee voters, more than quadruple the number from 2004.
It's fine. It's done and over with now.
In Colorado, voters waited up to 3 hours to get it done and over with. In Florida, massive lines forced the governor to extend early voting hours. And in North Carolina, a record 40% of registered voters, 2.6 million people, have already pulled the lever.
Get here at 6 and be in the front, or get here at 9, be in the street.
Here in D.C. and around the country, the early voting numbers may be unprecedented, but they're not altogether unsurprising. Not in a race where the candidates spent 2 years and a combined $1 billion trying to win over voters.
I'm just a young volunteer calling on behalf of McCain Campaign.
At the end of the day, I think we're going to have 2/3 of Americans vote, which would set the record for the century.
The weather certainly won't stand in their way, says meteorologist Topper Shutt at CBS affiliate WUSA in Washington.
Pockets of unsettled weather, yes. Some showers in the northwest, a few showers pushing into the northern plain states, and a little bit of rain showers across the southeast. But really, in terms of early November, we're lucky.
Leading several states to predict that lines like these are only a hint of what's to come tomorrow. Nancy Cordes, CBS News, Washington.